Rico and Kayla is about to go live online. Catch All Out Monster Hit Music, All Out Celebrity Interviews, All Out Showbiz and Sports News, All Out Fun, an exclusive on the Monster. Catch the stream on the Monster Facebook page at RX931, the Monster YouTube channel at RX931, and twitch.tv/MonsterRX931. Your All Out hosts, Rico Robles and Kayla Rivera. Stand by and enjoy the program.
On the Monster, it's all about giving you guys what's hot, what's exciting. And this time around, we did mention early in the week, it's all about showbiz royalty. Now, today, he has a new song, new single that he's coming out with. And let's just say we're going to trace back the family tree, how far we could go. He is a very good-looking man. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up. First time on the show, none other than Diego Gutierrez. What's up, man?
What's up, guys? What's up, Rico? Thanks for having me here. It's a pleasure.
No problem, man. How's everything going? I love the setup with the whole guitar and all. How's everything so far? Yes.
Everything's good. Just here at home today, trying to write some music, trying to cook up some new songs. So, yeah, just chilling today. And just want to say thank you again for having me here. It's an awesome opportunity.
You know, it's awesome to have your song. So, you know, we're going to catch the video later. By the end of the interview, we're going to check out the video, which features none other than, of course, Pinoy Big Brother Celebrity Edition big winner, Angie. That's part of the very, very nice music video. Now, you know, Diego, for those who don't know, I think everybody knows already, but, you know, how did you get started in the industry, man? You know, in show business, when did you decide, okay, it's time for me to start?
Well, I think I was pretty much born into it, like you were mentioning a while ago, the showbiz royalty. All my family is in showbiz, technically. And, you know, I just started. I graduated a couple of years ago, 2018. And then that was the only rule that our parents had, was to finish school before entering showbiz. And then after I graduated, I played basketball first for a while. And then when the pandemic hit, I was able to have the opportunity to enter showbiz, and it's been a good ride so far.
I mean, if you were to take it back, okay, we're going to go to the family tree I did mention. And we could see it at some mukha mo din eh, in traces of the members of the family. Let's start first with the grandparents, okay? So is it great-grandparents or grandparents?
I think it started with my grandparents. So all four of them are in showbiz. In my dad's side, it's Eddie Gutierrez and Pilita Corrales. And then in my mom's side, it's Christopher De Leon and Nora Honor. So that's where it starts.
My goodness. That is not just, you know, showbiz royalty, but the creme de la creme of awards and everything. And of course, your sister as well. Actually, your whole family, your dad Monching, as well as in showbiz. And also your mom, Lotlot, also in showbiz. Then your sister, Janine. Are you the younger sibling of Janine Gutierrez?
I am the younger sibling. She's a little bit older than me.
Now, when it came to show business, I know people see you sa ASAP, di ba? So when you decided, is it music that you wanted to get into, or you wanted to get into acting as well?
I think for now, my main focus is really my music, just trying to create music and share it with people. But eventually, if the opportunity comes for me to act, then I would be super willing to do that as well.
I mean, ang galing eh, kasi, you know, I was listening, the track that you're hearing people in the background is actually a song, Sino Na Tayo. We'll be playing the music video in just a bit. Now, what makes us unique is that your label that you're signed under, it's not a locally based label. So tell us about, you know, Hitmakers. Tell us about the label, how they found you.
Yeah, so Hitmakers Entertainment, it's a label based in Los Angeles, California, where there's only three artists for now in Hitmakers Entertainment. And one of the co-owners of this label is actually my dad's cousin. His name is Mark Feist, my dad's first cousin. And he's worked with people like Beyonce, Celine Dion, and all the likes of the stars in the States. So yeah, one time we visited the States, and then he just heard me singing behind in the back seat, and then he was like, why not try a career in music? So that's how that happened. That's how we signed a deal with his record label.
And big time, ah. Alam mo yun, kumakanta ka lang. So people out there, they're then, right? So if you have a record executive in front of you, your dad's friend or your dad's cousin, a family member, sing. Take that chance. And, you know, the song that you're hearing, it has a very 80s drive music. It reminds you of, you know, of Sab Rock, of John Mayer. I mean, was that the vibe that you're going for?
Actually, John Mayer's been a really huge inspiration for my music also. My dad was the one who put us on to John Mayer. He's been listening to John Mayer since he started with his first album. And yeah, John Mayer, lots of inspiration from that. And also The Weeknd's recent album with a lot of 80s beats and stuff like that. So yeah, those are the ones that I was trying to emulate also with my music, with my latest single.
Now, Jego, of course, Sino Na Tayo is a song that you have written. And the story about this song, can you tell us a story? Can you walk us through what inspired you to write a song like this?
Okay, so it's basically about a struggle, a point in time in the relationship where the two partners are struggling. And this guy, he still longs for them to fix this relationship. So if you listen to the song, it's pretty upbeat and you can dance to it. But if you listen to the lyrics, it's actually a little bit hugot, lots of hugot lines in there. So we tried to contrast that. And yeah, I think it worked pretty well also.
And the music video is very, very unique. You know, who thought of, is Angie your friend? Or is it more of like, let's cast somebody who's going through, you know, some sort of a different feeling? How did Angie Salvacion get in the music video?
Angie's a really good friend of mine. We've been working together since like 2 years ago in ASAP. We actually started together. Our first appearances were ASAP were at the same day in the same prod. So we started together and she's getting really big now and she's still so humble and such a good friend. And so thankful for her too, for agreeing to be part of the music video.
So right now, you know, on air, well, you know what? We're going to check out the song. I'm going to play the music video here on our interview, but I'll let it play on air as well so people could hear it. And then we're going to get to know more of Diego Gutierrez, what's in store that's coming up. Keep it locked in here. Once again, if you have questions for Diego, feel free to comment. 0961-367-931. You comment here as well on our Facebook Live. Lagi kang aking hinahanap. Araw gabi ay pinapangarap. Makita muli at ika'y mayakap. Hanggang tayo'y tumanda na. Nagtatakang bakit ika'y luminsan. Di ka man lang sa'kin nagpaalam. Sana'y naging panaginip lang ang lahat at ikaw ay nasa'king kapal. Diego, yeah, Diego Gutierrez, of course, joining us. Such an awesome treat. We got to catch a music video. Congratulations. You know, you're hearing in the background here as well on air. For those that are watching and for those that are tuning in, it's Monster RX 93.1. It's another Monster exclusive interview. Showbiz royalty joining us, getting into music. Is there pressure pag ganyan, Diego, that, you know, you got into show business, family is there. Was there any advice? Sino yung pinaka nakamando sa'yo when it comes to your career? Who's the one that's always telling you, okay, ito medyo ano?
I think it's a really a good balance. Like, kasi lahat ng pinagdadaanan ko ngayon, everything that I'm going through right now, my family already went through. So if there's like any problems, it's easy for me to ask advice and they give really good advice. And I'm really so thankful for that also for my family. And they're just very supportive. They don't push me into anything I don't want to do. And they just really have my back always.
What was that one advice that your Lola Pelita gave you when it comes to performing? We know that she is legendary when it comes to her backbend. You know, she has that iconic move that she does. I mean, did you ever ask her for advice when you were getting into show business?
Yeah, of course. Especially during like performances, I always ask her like how I should go about it. And she always just tells me to just be confident. And kapal ng mukha is her term that I should always go for when I'm on the stage. So that, you know, be confident, be proud that I'm on the stage and always perform like it's my last. So that's what I always bring.
And now let's break it down to the music. The music is great. Now in comes the question, is this just going to be a single or is it going to be a full album? Is there going to be an EP? What's in store for you, man, for the rest of the year?
For now, I'm just writing more and more songs to drop as singles. And then eventually, of course, we'll release an album, maybe an EP first. But in the near future, we'll have more singles coming out, maybe 2 to 3 more this year, hopefully. And yeah, super excited to share that with everyone, definitely.
You know, those are tuning up, Diego Gutierrez, he is joining us. And then, you know, with this one as well, people are commenting, ang ganda ng sound, hindi raw pilit. People are enjoying the music, ang ganda-ganda ng vibe. To Fonzie Manipis, thank you for keeping it locked in here. Thank you for the message. Also, you know, Diego, for you, I mean, you do come from an international label that got you signed, Hitmakers. Now, is there any future collaborations? And if so, if any artist wants to collaborate with you, how can they collaborate with you, man?
It's easy to reach out to me. They can just message me and I'll be able to message my record label. We don't really have any conflicts when it comes to collaborating. So yeah, hopefully that's also something that I plan to do, that I want to collaborate with more artists here in the Philippines. And yeah, hopefully that happens soon, definitely.
And how about shows? Where can they catch you live? Other than ASAP. I know there's ASAP on Sundays. But for you, where can they catch you live? Are you going to be having some sets and some shows as well coming up?
None yet so far. Just ASAP for now. Every Sunday, you can catch me there with the Sessionistas and the new breed of singers. So that's it for now. And you can just tune in on my Instagram and my Twitter at Diego D. Goods for future shows, for future sets. So I hope you guys just watch out.
All right, Diego. Well, thank you very much for taking time to join us. Your song, Sino Na Tayo, is a really, really great song. And you're excited. Sana you have more. And from then, we'll have you live in the studio. You know, you want to thank some people? You want to invite them again also to request for the songs here at The Monster? Go ahead.
Yes, I just want to thank everyone for all the support so far. The music video has been getting a bunch of streams and on Spotify also. So I just want to thank everyone for all the support. I hope you guys keep streaming, keep watching the video. And yeah, thank you all to my family also for just being so supportive. And yeah, more music to come for sure. Hope you guys watch out for that. And thank you also to The Monsters. The Monster, thank you so much for having me for this opportunity also.
And anytime, Diego, you know, just keep on making that music, man. And, you know, message for those who are creating music like you, na medyo nahihiya pa to step out of their bedroom to perform live on stage and record that song. Go ahead, now's your chance, man.
Yeah, if anyone's telling you that you can't do it, just chase your dreams. Just go after it. Don't listen to them. If you think you have it in you, just go for it. That's how it's gonna happen. You just have to trust yourself and trust the process, trust the system, and everything will go well. That's it.
And with showbiz families, I know everybody wants to create their own name. Jego, for you, in the Gutierrez family, in the De Leon family, how would you want to be known for?
I just want to be known for probably inspiring other people who want to do something that they're afraid to do. Because, you know, me, sometimes I get afraid to put out new songs, or even posting on Instagram, it's scary. So I just want to inspire people that if I can do it, you can do it too. So that's what I want to address to all the people. Just don't be scared and just be yourself and be confident.
Hey, best said, my man. You have a great weekend, and thank you for taking time to join us here on the show. Okay?
Thank you so much.
All right, man. Take care always. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise with Diego Gutierrez. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much. Nice to meet you guys.
Thanks, man. Nice to meet you, my man. There you have it once again. Sino na tayo are about to hear here on The Monster. Don't forget to request for his songs. Sino na tayo by Diego Gutierrez at RX931. Till then, my name is Yuko Robles. That was pretty awesome. That has been another awesome Monster interview on behalf of Kayla Rivera. Till then, thank you for watching.
Monster exclusive interview. Monster exclusive interview. Only from Manila's hottest. Monster RX 93.1.